love and space. Turks had plenty of it. The Elan of Troyes, Miramani, Kalinda, Nona, Drusilla, the list goes on. A girl on every planet, most of them even humanoid. Mr. Spock, too, has had his share of women trying to melt his hard Vulcan heart. Layla, Droxine, Zarabeth, and even a female Romulan commander. In this episode, it's Dr. Leonard McCoy's turn to find love. We know he was once married before he joined Starfleet and that the marriage ended in divorce. In our interstellar travels, we met one of the doctor's girlfriends, or a likeness of her, in the Mantrap. This time, it's going to be the real thing for our southern country doctor. Now, for the world is hollow, and I have touched the sky. This episode first aired during Star Trek's third and final season. Our audience was declining, and everyone connected to the show was feeling pressure from the network. Although we beat the Klingons and the Romulans, we eventually were defeated in the ratings war. In past seasons, we had been up against shows like My Three Sons and Gomer Pyle. The last year we were on the air, our competition was Judd for the Defense. In the 3 years we were on the network, we never did better than 54th place. But at that time, who would ever have thought what a phenomenon Star Trek would become over the years? Dictatorship by computer. Decisions made by a cold, hard, calculating entity that leaves no room for dissent. It doesn't get more efficient than that. But it's hard to imagine a less compassionate form of government than a computer. In Star Trek, these electronic despots fortunately never survived beyond the end of the episode, thanks, of course, to James T. Kirk.